Praise y'all. Praise God. Praise God. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. Hallelujah to his name. Give God praise. Thank him for waking us up this morning. The picture that you see is the title of my video. This is Joshua Brown, 28 years old, that was actually slain. So let me get to my point this morning. Praise God. Praise God. And I need you to share this, as always, because it's very powerful. What God reveals, because you cannot heal if God don't reveal what's really going on. Praise God. Praise God. And so my title is Joshua Brown's murder was a hit. Wake up. This is the 60s all over again. Praise God. But we always want to wake up giving God praise, giving him honor, giving him glory. And I'm going to get straight into my video. You know, I don't even think I slept last night. This really bothered my spirit. And I'm going to go ahead and tell y'all, you know, being prophetic, people don't understand. That's why I dislike the spirit of false prophets, because, you know, you take away from it from what it really is, meaning that it's the burden of the Lord. It's like I didn't even sleep because my spirit was so vexed the whole night through. And I'm not kidding. It's like I was asleep, but I wasn't asleep. I kept seeing this young man's face and I kept seeing him as a martyr. Now I'm going to go somewhere. It reminds me of the 60s, Mega Evers, you know, Dr. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X. I don't know if y'all understand the season we in, the times that we in. God said this is the 60s all over again, slavery, where they think to pit us against one another, because that was a hit. That was a paid hit, by the way. So, and I don't know if y'all understand what's really going on. I'm talking about the bigger picture here. But through it all, God says to be strong. Let me go ahead and say that. God says be strong. But the only way you can be strong is by the power of God. And that's why the enemy in this season is trying to make people believe that you can do this in your own power and it cannot be done. Come on, somebody. That was the only way that Dr. Martin Luther King, Mega Evers, even Malcolm X, it doesn't matter who they believed or what they believed, so say. You have to have a strong spirit in order to stand up for righteousness in this hour for God. Y'all ain't ready for me. Come on, somebody. This young man was brave when no one else wanted to testify, that heard and saw what was going on. So I pray for his mother. I pray for his family. And I salute Joshua Brown. I don't care what nobody say, because that young man, you could say, was an activist and definitely a martyr. It does not matter what nobody say or think. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. 28 years old and he stood up knowing. Because I got to tell y'all something. One thing about being a prophetic, you have a knowing. He knew what was going to happen. He could have moved. He could have did something different. He knew. He didn't want to bring that to his family or his friends. You know, because he knew. He felt it. I'm telling you what God say. Hallelujah to his name. Oh, praise God, praise God. But woe unto those that had everything to do with it, because this was a paid hit. And it's almost like black on black crime again, because to be honest with you, what he said was predominantly black. You know, I mean, they have half and half, but you know what I'm saying. It's like people are always watching. So what is the best way to mix in? It's just like when Jesus was a baby, they say he hid in Egypt, hid around his own kind, right? Y'all know where I'm going with this. So y'all know who they paid to do this. Y'all know what I'm saying? Point blank. And here's the deal. I was looking at something last night and I wasn't even thinking about this, because I had to pull myself back for a moment. And just as clear as day, God told me the whole story. And I really got upset. I said, God, it's just like back in the slavery days. We're going to use this one to take out that one. And all we got to do is pay them money. Because right now, the enemy got everybody doing anything for money. You will kill your brother and your sister for a dollar. You will kill this one. You will kill that one. But woe unto you, God says, that does such things. Hallelujah. For you shall open up your eyes in hell. I'm telling you what thus saith the Lord. This stuff is real. But let me get to the point of the matter. God is saying this is a warning for everybody. They are trying. They ain't trying. They're trying to do a race war. This is hatred. This is hatred. This is hatred in the worst kind. Y'all need to understand what spirit is behind all this. All the killings, all this unfairness, all this stuff is going on. And let me tell y'all what God says. God says the only way that we're going to be strong is through his spirit. You cannot do this in revenge. You can't get up on social media, start cussing, acting a fool. You can only do this by the spirit of God. Don't forget the power of God, y'all. I don't care what God allows. Oh, come on, somebody. See, God made Pharaoh for this day. And believe it or not, we are in a Pharaoh system and Pharaoh seems stronger. Oh, come on, somebody. Pharaoh got more than us. Y'all got to understand what I'm saying here. But the power of God is still real. The power of God will make anybody back up. Remember, he told Pharaoh, I made you to destroy you. God is going to destroy the Pharaoh system once again. But we have to stand strong in the Lord, not strong against each other. It's too much bickering. It's too much, you know, shadiness. It's too much shystiness, meaning that I have never seen deception this high since I have been born. Hallelujah. And I've been on this earth 51 years, and I've never seen the deception I see in today's society. Meaning you can't trust nobody without the spirit and wisdom and discernment of God. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. You can't just do it that way. You can't do it any kind of way. We have a system right now that's trying to, let me tell you, thank you, Lord. Let me walk this thing out. Let me slow myself down. I hear you, God. God is saying that they're trying to install fear in us. It started from Trayvon Martin, Michael Brown, Alton Sterling. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying? They still doing the same thing. They're trying to install fear in as if you're afraid to die. Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all ain't ready for me. Everybody else, yes, I know this is a sad thing, but I salute Joshua Brown. That's what I'm talking about. I ain't talking about the enemy this morning. I don't give them no glory. I salute this young man for having the spirit of God. Hallelujah. The spirit of righteousness to stand up when everybody else was acting like a coward. Yeah, I said it. So what am I saying? The whole moral of this post? You better believe in God like never before in this hour. You better pay close attention to what's going on. Do not allow fear to cancel your faith. That's what the enemy is trying to do. He's trying to create fear in this world like never before. That's what God says. But God says he is still God. He is still the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. Oh, hallelujah. He said they all shall bow down. They shall worship him, said the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. So I'm telling you right now. Saints, you need to start praying over your families. I've been saying this for months. Pray over your children. Pray over your city. Pray over your state. And understand one thing. The enemy is here. Y'all don't understand what I'm saying. The devil is strong in this hour because God is allowing it. But don't get it twisted. He does not have the glory. He does not have all power, says the Lord. Remember Luke 10:19. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You know, and that's why I also like dislike the spirit of fake preachers, because y'all so busy faking until people don't have the real power of God to sustain. You can't do this but by the power of God. God says not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. The only way you can really help a nation, a people, your people, is by the spirit of the living God. And therefore, you must walk in righteousness, because God says the prayer of the righteous availeth much. You can't do nothing if you in sin. And that's not trying to glorify nobody, not even myself. But you can't do nothing if you are in sin. It cannot be done, saith the Lord. It cannot be done. Hallelujah. You can't. And so now you got a people that's not really, that's actually, this is a lucrative business. Preaching is a lucrative business. People doing all kind of stuff for money. And y'all love to have it so. When you're supposed to use wisdom and discernment. I don't pour just into anybody. I just can't do it. Because I would not have a covenant with a devil. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. You won't have no power. So I'm just saying to continue to pray. Continue to fast. I told you we stopped fasting on the 29th of last month. And again, this is not to glorify like I'm all that. Come on, somebody. This stuff, being a true saint, a true Christian, a true child of God, it's not easy, honey. You got to work that thing out. You got to walk that thing out. You got to pray that thing out. And you have to fast it out. Y'all want to see change? Let me tell you something. The Bible says this kind come out but by fasting and praying. My God. I'm just saying. And Lord have mercy. My spirit is vexed. My spirit is vexed. But you know what? Now I know why God won't allow me to stop fasting, you know, and I'm very transparent on purpose. You know, God is so, he's so more intelligent than us. I don't care what anybody says. He outwits us because he's God. And I thought that, you know, I was doing this for myself, just to be honest with you, you know, as far as praying, getting stronger. And I and what I mean by that is, you know I have to lose the weight, right? And it was so funny when God really showed me what this was about. I was like, oh my God, you know, and I understand I've never been a selfish type person. Don't get it twisted. But I was thinking, okay, I'm doing this for A, B, C, D. Man, I am doing this for a whole nation, meaning that, and I hope that my walk helps you to walk holy, help you to want to think more about your others than yourself. You know, pray. Everybody's into this entertainment spirit. Everybody's into feeling good, wanting to do what you want to do. Can I tell you something? When you truly begin to serve God, you don't do what you want to do. You do what you need to do. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You're not selfish. You know what time it is. You know that you have to pay a price. Come on, somebody. It's called sacrifice. Hallelujah. We have to pray like never before in this hour, people. You have to get up in the morning. I don't remember going to bed till like maybe, I knew it was like in the morning and look up, and I got up like maybe an hour ago, maybe an hour and a half. I don't remember. All I know is, and then, like I said, it doesn't even feel like I slept. It's like I was groaning the whole night through as if I was this young man's mother. It's the spirit is real. As a matter of fact, the spirit is more real than the flesh. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So I pray in the name of Jesus that you really understand what I'm saying here, because we have a system, but more so we have a church that's unchurched, that really don't know the spirit of God, really don't know how to move in the spirit, walk in the spirit, talk in the spirit. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you right now, I was praying, it was the other day, and I'm going to share something with you. I said, God, I want more of you. I want more of you. Oh, come on, somebody. I want more of you. And hold on. It's not to glorify myself. I want to get so anointed to where soon as I speak, it's done. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm not talking about an hour. No, soon. Because when I read in the Bible about Elijah, come on, somebody, about Jeremiah, about Haggai, about Ezekiel, about Isaiah, I understand the power they had. Oh, come on, somebody. We should desire the same power. And hold on, not for ourselves, but to help our nation, our people, to become stronger in the Lord. That's what this is about. You cannot do this without being strong in the Lord. And people are trying to do it, and you will wear yourself out because the enemy thinks to wear us out. Don't you understand what the fight is about? They want martial law. They want new world order. They're not playing. This is coming whether you like it or not, whether you believe it or not, whether you say here she go again. It really doesn't matter. I suggest you prepare yourself mentally, physically, and spiritually like never before, and definitely emotionally. Because we have a weak nation. I read yesterday, and this happened like in the next town. I'm in Augusta, and it's like maybe 15, 20 minutes away. There was a young man that actually pinned his mother down. This happened yesterday now. Pinned his mother down, and he wiped the sweat off his buttocks in her face. Okay, y'all understand what I'm saying, right? What kind of demonic stuff is that? Don't y'all understand what's going on? Then I saw what happened up maybe 2 or 3 days ago when this older lady was at the gas station and these two young men threw her down. Well, she looked like she had just went in, paid, and I don't know if she left her truck open or what, but they had got in the truck and then one of them beat her. You know, not bad, 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 but he still put his hands on her. And and then stole the truck. If y'all don't see what time it is, the enemy is getting in people like never before. You guys got to be ready. You can say what you want. I'm a woman of God, but I'm going to tell you right now, roll up on me if you want to. Yeah, I'm saying it like that. Roll up on me if you want to. I might as well just tell it because I want to encourage y'all. Honey, I'm packing. You can say what you want to say. Yeah, I love the Lord. I sure do, but I ain't crazy. Not only that, I'm getting my body in shape. Y'all know I used to work for the FBI, so you already know I got skills, and I suggest you get some too. Carry something. Pepper spray. Yeah, I'm saying what you think I'm saying. These demons done lost their mind. People are rolling up on people doing all kind of stuff. We're in the last hour. What you think going on? Play if you want to. Prepare yourself, said the Lord. That's wisdom. They ain't acting crazy or thuggish. That's wisdom. Ooh, hallelujah. I'm just being real. I'm sorry. No, I ain't going out like that. Now, if God say, don't do anything, Deanna, you know, then that's fine. But if he don't say it, the devil is a lie. I don't like people that, no, I'm going to say it like this. I don't like that spirit that's trying to hurt people, kill people, steal people, rob. If you guys don't understand what spirit that is Satan. That is not God. And that's just like breaking your brothers and sisters' spirit. God ain't going to tell you to assassinate your brothers and sisters' character. Unless it's a thus saith the Lord. And then he's going to try to tell you to get in touch with them first. Y'all doing stuff all out of order. And you wonder why there's no order. And God is a God of order. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. But again, I applaud this young man. I want to remember his name to the day I die. Point blank in the story. Because, I did a lot of research. He was really an honorable person. And for to stand up when no one else wanted to. So many people had heard what happened in the apartment building that they didn't want to come forward. He knew what would happen. He had a sense because he apparently had talked to some friends and said that he was scared something was going to happen, you know. But I applaud him because most people would have moved in with their mom or they whoever. He kept that stuff from them because he knew. And so it takes a brave person. It takes a man of God, a woman of God to stand up and say, God, I serve you regardless of what happens to me. Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all better get in reality because the world and came in, got everybody thinking this is Hollywood. This is not a movie. This stuff is real. And they're showing you what they're doing. Come on, somebody. Because, you know, and prophetic is real because God will tell you details. I'm not going to say, y'all know what time, but y'all knew this woman was a cop, so y'all already know who had that young man killed, but I'm going to tell you something. Whether you put his address on a site of hate or whatever, you still guilty. Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all know they killed him, you know, y'all understand what's going on, right? Woo, Lord have mercy. The devil is his, said the Lord. So, and yes, I have a righteous anger this morning. Oh, God, I do. I've been having one for a couple of days when I saw two young thugs. So that's what they are. Pull that woman out of our door on the ground and take her vehicle. You got to use wisdom. And thank you, Lord, I hear you. God says use wisdom and discernment and be alert. I'm not saying run around here in fear. That's not what I'm saying. But you have to use wisdom. Most of you are just walking around like, okay, everything's just fine. No, it's not. Sorry. This world is topsy-turvy. You don't know what might pop off. So God bless you. God keep you. And I just pray that you guys are really understanding what's going on here. That's all. Yeah, broad daylight, these bold demons. Exactly, Miss Linda. And it's just too much. It's too much and it's not of God. And yes, the power of God is real. But sometimes you know, y'all know, I ain't going to say too much because people are like, oh, she promoting this? Whatever. You say what you want to say. I keeps it real. I don't know what's wrong with y'all, but I keep it 100. I am not finna lie. And I'm not finna sugarcoat nothing for nobody. But I do know at the end of that thing, it better be God. So I just pray. Let me pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, everybody that comes in the sound of my voice, Father God, first of all, I pray for this young man's family, mother, friends, Father God. I pray that they are strong and they understood that he was a hero. You know, so yes, it's sad, but he still was a hero. Praise God. Hallelujah. So Father God, I just thank you for everybody that it will listen to this video, Father God, that you strengthen their mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally, Father God, that you let them know, Father God, to walk in faith and not fear. The enemy is trying to put us in fear by all these tactics or whatever the case he's doing. But Father God, I know that you are still all powerful. You are God, Father God, all by yourself. Is there anything too hard for you, God? So Father God, I pray that you just strengthen everybody, Father God, by the power of the Holy Ghost, the power of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, the fire of God, the power of God. Oh, Father God, heal and deliver your people like never before, Father God. Hallelujah, God. I plead the blood of Jesus over their mind, their body, their soul, God. Do what you want to do, God, how you want to do it, when you want to do it. Even you don't even have to tell us why, God. Oh, Father God, I pray that you continue to walk with them, cover them, Father God, protect them, Father God. I pray for the children, Father God. I pray for everybody over this world, Father God, in this land, Father God, in the name of Jesus. You say, if my people, which are called by my name, would humble themselves, then I will heal their land. Oh, Father God, I pray for a spirit of humbleness, Father God, a spirit of faith, Father God, like never before, a spirit of love, to love each other again. There's a spirit of hate going, Father God, and I rebuke it. I sever it to the root of that thing. Satan, you cannot have what is God's in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, Father God, I thank you, God. We give you honor and we give you praise. And we seal this prayer with the precious blood of the Lamb. Oh, Father, protect your children, the children, the people that they're stealing. I will have to pray for them. Father God, I just pray that you continue to have everybody be on guard when they're out and about, Father God. Oh, Father God, keep your people like never before. We thank you, God. We give you honor and we give your praise, and we plead the blood of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. This prayer will not be hindered, stopped, or blocked, but will accomplish what it was sent out to do in Jesus Christ of Nazareth's name. Oh, hallelujah. Amen, amen, and amen. I pray that you have a blessed day. I pray that you just don't go to church today, but I pray that you will, and you cry and you pray. And I keep telling y'all, God says fast, 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 fast. That is so important. This kind come out but by fasting and praying. There are demons. I have never seen the demonic force so heavy. Do y'all understand what I'm saying? I've never seen it, even in the churches, because everybody's running after money. Can I tell you something? It's going to be a time where they're going to throw money in the street. It's not going to be invaluable. Excuse me. I'm serious, you guys. Excuse me. I'm sorry, you guys. Just got through drinking water. But please, please, please understand what time it is. The season we're in, it's time to pray and fast like never before. I'm gonna keep praying. I don't know when I'm gonna stop. I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna keep praying. I'm gonna do my part. I think we all have, as a matter of fact, ain't no thinking, we all have assignments. Are you about your Father's business? It's not about us. So be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So roll out, soldiers, for that is who we are. God bless.